refers to instance of entities that have access to records, person-related entities, organization-related entities, groupings created for access to master data. Remember, humne baat ki thi, the main purpose of party model is access control, better access control. We want to utilize the same field, same MVG, to provide the access to not just employees. In Siebel 6, that... So look at this field. Okay, look at this field, sales team. I'm sure you know that. So this team here, you know that you in Siebel 6, you could choose only employees. Okay, you could only choose positions, basically only positions. Okay, now the requirement in Siebel 7 was that they wanted the rep should be able to choose organizations so that he can assign the opportunity to the entire organization or another access group or maybe to another even account or maybe to some employee directly. So that is the reason it started. So basically they started the whole party model to accommodate this particular requirement. Person related entities, organization related entities, groupings created for access to master data, all these can be now configured using. So basically you're saying that, you know, they want the access to records. So now to give the access to records, we want to be able to enter person there, not just a position. Similarly, organization related entities, we want to be able to enter an organization there in the same MVG. Okay.
Okay. So,
okay. So yeah, these are some different entities, and the whole idea is we should have, this is the main idea. This pick applet, this MVG and this pick applet should show all the entities. It is not possible. Behind the scenes, as you said, so it's basically used for, you know, ensuring that, you know, different kinds of data can be allowed the access using just one pickup MVG applet and pick applet. Okay,
so basically
basically a MVG applet that pick applet is basically mapped to a BC, so that BC is mapped to a certain table.
See, basically when we see the funda, when we go to the base
mm-hmm.
The thing is that a field in an applet, first let's go to the applet. An applet that we see on the UI is mapped to a BC in the business logic layer.
Mm-hmm.
That BC is mapped to a table
mm-hmm.
in the database layer,
mm-hmm.
Level.
Mm-hmm.
So each and every field that we see on that applet
mm-hmm.
is mapped to the corresponding columns of that table.
Correct.
So when in a field, if it's a MVG or if it's a pick applet, when a user opens the pick applet, then that table is shown with different columns. That columns are nothing but the same controls that you see on the UI.
Correct.
So okay. That means it's just a one table. So now, said that table is l_org.ext.
Uh-huh.
But the requirement is in the same applet, mm-hmm. you want the user to pick the data
mm-hmm.
from a different table, from more than one table.
Correct.
A BC can be mapped to just one table at a time.
Correct.
So it can represent data just from that table.
Correct.
So what's the solution of getting data from the other table?
Correct.
The solution is make a common table.
Mm-hmm.
Make a common table that gets data from different tables that you want to map to the same BC. And that map that BC to that common table, which is nothing but the s_party table.
So, yeah. This table is already made in Siebel. And you know, there are rules like, you know, what all tables are sharing the data with it.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll come to know about this thing in a few. How person-related data is stored, how organization, basically at a high level, three types of data are stored in it. Person-related, organization-related, and groupings-related. Koi group banaya hua unhi cheezon ka. Theek hai? Represents anyone associated with a Siebel application, we know that. Person, contact, employee, all these are basically person. Maybe someone using the application or user also. Customer is also. Sometimes customer access through the portal, right? E-service and e-sales. Yes, they are also persons. Everybody together. Employee at a company that deployed a Siebel application, individual at a channel partner, customer logging into the website, referred to in the application, individual external to your company associated. So all these partners also, partner employees also, they're also persons. all these, if you want to, you know, they all mapped into that table, basically. Yeah. They're all having group their data grouped into that table, okay? Store their main data in S underscore content, may store additional data in S underscore user and S import, okay? So a user is a content that can log in, that is who has a user ID. So he has a user ID, password. Now an employee also has a user ID, password. So all his user ID details will be in the user table. All his employee related details will be in the emp per table. All his content and first name, last name will be in the content table. Okay. That's how basically Siebel works. Okay. Now all person related business component, these are various person related business components. Okay. So these all will be having the data in the S underscore party. That's a basic funda, right?
Yeah.
Multiple business components use these tables. Consumer, he's saying there are multiple, you know, BCs which basically use the same table. Okay.
The same party table.
He's just talking about base, yeah. You know more than he's talking about.
Yes.
Relationships for responsibility. Basically, we know that there is an intersection table for content and the responsibility. So that's fine. Okay. Organization related data. Represents any business enterprise associated with a Siebel application. The company, the organization itself, in context of Siebel, organization means the one who's implementing Siebel. Mm-hmm. Or account, an external company that purchases your product, that is account. Or channel partner, a company with which you are partnered. They all are related. Store their meta in S underscore org underscore ext. May store additional data in S underscore bu. S underscore org underscore ext. S underscore bu. Right? Store their main data in S underscore org underscore ext. May store additional data in S underscore bu. Okay. So they are saying that organization, yeah, Davis, all their data is in S underscore. If it is an organization that is internal organization, then it will be having some data additional. Basically, the organization itself will be having additional data in S underscore bu. Uh-huh. Okay. So this is the way this it does. Okay. Ye bhi aapko dikh jayega. Ye apne kaamon ke list mein hai. S underscore bu table, basically it has the organization name. Okay, mainly intern, the way organization is called in Siebel, like, you know, like for example, if Dell is implementing Siebel, then Dell is the org, right? That is there in this table. Okay. Yes. Well, there are only a few additional instances, sorry, allows them to get sorry by the name, other than such as counts, the name.
These are the accounts which are external and which are the customers, and these are the units internal.
Yeah, be business units.
Business units.
So you remember how we talked about multiple organizations in Siebel? If there are multiple organizations, they will be created like that.
You never know, maybe each division is considered as an organization.
Yeah.
Probably.
Yeah. Division level, basically, remember we talked about organization-based visibility? Yeah. Geography location is typically mapped to the organization.
Okay.
When we have the visibility of data constraints, chapter 11. Okay. Is implemented by the BU underscore ID foreign key column in the table for a single organization business component. Okay. Single organization visibility. Okay. Basically, if you want, let's say contact, this contact needs to get the, you know, you want to know which BU it is a part of, then you just store a foreign key here for this. What is a BU ID is basically mapped to the row ID. This line tells you that this BU ID is pointing to row ID. And there's a one-to-many relationship. So on the many side, there is a foreign key, which is going to the primary key of the BU. But this is single organization. What if this guy works for multiple organizations? This contact is dealt by North America, Dell, as well as by Dell Canada, then. As well as by Dell South America, then. These are all business riddles. We have already done that. Is implemented by an intersection table. You know that. That means we need an intersection table. There is a many-to-many relationship, so we need an intersection table. In this case, he says in case of price list and organization, this is the name of the intersection table. Consists of business components that represent people and organization units. Party, these are the party business components. All these are the ones which go in that table. Simply reference the S underscore party table. A way to think of party is that it is an abstraction of the business component that own records.
So all these are BC.
Okay. So all these BCs, as our knowledge goes, are supposed to be mapped to the respective tables. For example, contact should be mapped to S underscore contact. But in the light of the new knowledge, these are actually mapped to S underscore party. So that when they're storing data, they should store in S party as well as in their own table. Otherwise, if they are mapped directly to S underscore org underscore ext, they will not store anything in S underscore party.
Okay, mm-hmm. So they are mapped like that so that they at least do something in essence of party as well. Remember, we said that we yeah. want to goal is every time there is a record in account or contact or user or organization, it should have an entry in essence of party as well. Remember?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. So that is just possible only if they are mapped. These BCs are mapped to essence of party. Serves as the base table for all party business components. Stores the party name and party type. Okay, remember I told you party name and party type. So within, party table, it knows
the name and the type.
What is the importance of type? Type tells the engine that this is the table where it should go to get further details.
Okay.
Remember we just take the row IDs and put it in the party table, right?
Yeah.
We also keep party type so that it knows that for this particular ID, it should go further. For further details, it should go to S or EXT. And it's a type of account.
Yes, yes.
It stores that too.
Yeah, the type is nothing but like almost like a BC name, which yeah. differentiates between the primary keys.
Yeah, but here BC is not in the picture. Just at the table level, at it the tells table you level. That which table yes, should it go
which
to.
Which table it should go to.
Yeah, these are the types, various types. So party includes business components that represent groupings of party instances. See here. Access group grouping of it also includes any grouping. Sybil 7 mein groupings be allowed. Like basically you can make an access group which consists of these things, employee, user, or anything. And then you can assign the account record to the group. Then it will be visible to that entire group. Okay. S party per is an instance intersection table that relates two instances of parties used to implement relationship between user list and user, employee and position, access group and member. So this is second one is easy to understand. So remember we used to talk about employee and positions, like one employee has multiple positions and one position can be on multiple employees.
Mm-hmm.
These relationships are stored somewhere, right? This is many to many relationship.
Mm-hmm.
Now this relationship will be stored where? In an intersection table.
Mm-hmm.
The one foreign key will go to the
primary key
of which table? Party table.
Yes.
The other foreign key will go to the
party table
again. To a different row though.
Yes.
So one will be of the type employee, second one will be of the type position. And it will say this employee is having this position and this other position too and this other position too, right?
Yes.
Right? That's how this S party park works.
Okay.
Okay, okay. So account and contact also having many to many relationship. That means there should be a
intersection
table between party and party in that case also. Account is a party, contact is a party. If you make the foreign key in the intersection table point to org.ext and point to s_contact, then the purpose of party is not served. Relationship should be stored at the party level too.
Mm-hmm.
Every relationship, all those things have to be made at the party level.
At the party level.
Party table level. So we have to have a party to party relationship table for those two. It's going to come now. These are the relationships that are stored in S party per. Just remember this as a factual detail, okay? S party only, instead we used to store. Yep. Now you understand. If account business component is now, account business component is now mapped to s_party and s_contact. When the content BC throws data into Sybil, it will go into s_party table with the name and then the party type code will be contact and the rest of the things will still go in s_contact. Remember?
Mm-hmm.
They only just share their row IDs there. They put their row IDs.
Just the row IDs.
Yeah,
row in ID. The party table.
In the party table and the party type and maybe one and more
party
detail.
Type, yeah.
But basically these are the details there.
Yeah, these are the only details.
These are the only details there. Okay, no? So all these business components are now mapped to s_party as well as the corresponding business component. Okay? That's what he's trying to say.
Mm-hmm.
Relevance in subsequent entities. Configuring business components. What is the importance of saying all this? All person-related business components use s_contact. All organization-related business components use S or EXT. Over 100 party-related business components reference s_party but store the data in one of the many s_party extension tables. So in this context, S or EXT is called as an extension of S party.
Okay.
Importing data for party related business components. Must populate columns in s_party table in addition to tables that store the data of interest to users. Yep, it says जो मैंने हम बोल चुके हैं, नाउ इट हैज टू पॉपुलेट एज पार्टी ऑल्सो, पार्टी टेबल ऑल्सो.
ओके,
जस्ट बिकॉज अदरवाइज हाउ विल इट बिकम द कॉमन ग्रुपिंग. एंड दैट एक्सेस कंट्रोल थिंग दैट वी ओरिजिनल स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम द रिक्वायरमेंट विल नेवर गेट फुलफिल्ड. सो वी नीड टू हैव ऑल दिस थिंग्स देयर. इंपोर्टिंग डेटा फॉर बिजनेस कंपोनेंट्स रिलेटेड टू ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस. ठीक है, नाउ लेट्स से यू आर इंपोर्टिंग डेटा इन बल्क एंड योर आइडिया इज टू इंपोर्ट डेटा इन बल्क, अकाउंट डेटा इन बल्क एंड पुट इट इन सीबल. Can you just put it in as or EXT table? No. You have to put it some that as and as the party also have to be populated. That's the reason Siebel does not let the developers load data into Siebel. Because Siebel data has to go to multiple places. And Siebel will take care of it. It says just put it in the EIM table. I will suck it in. Look my word. Notice my word. Suck it in. I will absorb it myself. You don't please do any further thing. Okay?
Okay.
You know all the various tables, you know, where the party is used. Okay. So let's do some exercises right here. Okay. I typically go to Siebel 6 tools and SRF and sample file for connecting. But because 6 didn't even have party, so we cannot go there. Now I will go to 8. Okay. I am in Siebel 8, this thing, right? Installable installation. Go to sample, UTF-8. No, just a minute. Go to bin and I think ENU. It should be their name DBI SQL C, or it should be I SQL C. So it is in bin, not bin in you, and the name is DBI SQL. So you open it. It's a very simple thing. You enter the user ID password. Remember, caps lock should be on.
Mm-hmm.
So user ID password should be all caps. S admin, same thing. Okay. Now here you browse and go to the same. Okay. Uh-huh. It's in the, I'm in the same, right? Okay, I'm in 8.0. I should go to 8.1. Same, pick the sample database from here. You need to do all here to see the sample database file. This is, I have put it in E program. Just a minute. Moved all this. My sample database is not lying there, it's lying here. I have changed the SCFG file, and basically all these are lying here. But you should find out wherever your 8.1. This thing is, you should only go there, not everywhere, okay?
Oh.
These things are okay. Simple, right? I mean, make it always unblock. Let's see what happens. Okay. Just keep lag cap locks on because there are some things. Just see the columns. Row ID, created by, last updated by. These are common columns. These are in everything. So this is nothing special. We haven't seen anything special so far. Modification, configuration, this is again nothing special. Admin adjustment flag, something special. This is something special. Party type code, party UID, root party flag, last update, DB last update, again nothing special. Group type, this is a type, name, this is par row ID, party ID, that's it. There are just 6 or 7 columns. If you open sr.org.ext, you will see hundreds of columns. See, there's so many columns. Just see. See? Columns. Yep. So many columns. More columns. More columns. More columns. Party has nothing in comparison to that. Just the usual columns, which are in every table, and just additional few 4 or 5 columns. So it doesn't store data. Okay, let's see what sparty per has. Again, row ID created by, usual columns. This is again usual column, last updated by. Again, this thing, direct relationship flag, unusual column. Party ID, which one? Person ID, the person that it is related to. Reference flag. Admit flag, these are again unusual. Start date, comments, DB last updated, PR relation ID, reference type ID,
there are some columns here, relationship type ID, responsibility. So basically you will see, you know, you need to study the columns like this and see what is their purpose. Remember that data model, if you go to Siebel, go to a certain table, you press F1, or there is a report, if you run a report or something, I think, if you remember, you know, in this table, if you run a report, you go to this table and you press this, and then you go to reports and run table, then you can run a report on this table, and that's how it will come to know which this thing it is. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Remember?
Mm-hmm.
The purpose of each and every column is mentioned here.
Okay.
Of all the out-of-the-box columns, right?
Mm-hmm.
So you need to do that. Okay?
Mm-hmm.